Good morning, everyone. Sorry, I got a little late there on the day. And let's take a look at our markets. Okay. Yesterday, we were discussing the some opportunities where we were going to take some kind of counter long-term trend trades that we were doing, you know, looking at our various bear moves in the euro, the pound, and the Aussie dollar, New Zealand dollar, et cetera, et cetera, and the longs that we've been doing in the dollar yen, and looking at some probable counter trend trades here, looking at the, you know, the setups and the overextended zones that we're in a lot of these areas. So our first trade that we discussed yesterday was going long with the euro dollar at 120.29. That did not play out, but we are forming a base below here, so we may, you know what, I'm not even sure I want to execute any trades today. I may not issue anything because we don't have a clear direction and we're just pausing. So I'm just going to hang. I mean, there may be some. I just, we want to, you can see the clear indecision set up in these hourly candlesticks. The dollar yen, looking here, and we see that we wanted to go short at 109.61. That one was more in play yesterday. We did get a bit of a drop there, but we really did not get down to that 109.61 zone. We just kind of, we stopped really kind of right above it, so we did not get to break down below that zone, and we're still kind of basing below this other angle. So we're just kind of resting here right above that 618 fib line as well. Just kind of a tight zone right now. Gold, we wanted to do a long scalp at 1309, and we did get that. And that is currently active, but I actually peeled off profit on this last night. Actually, I'm pretty flat right now. Except I don't know why it triggered, but there was a short on gold that triggered on the MAM account. I don't know why. Well, I know why, I just don't know how I got it there. That's okay though. Aussie dollar, we were looking at going long at 75.13. We did get up to 75.13, and we are currently resting right above the 75. So we are in a kind of a very touchy area, right above the 75 zone. But I am looking at a long entry here on the short term. All right, and then the NZD New Zealand dollar pair wanted to go long at a return to 70.34, which we did not get. But we are still kind of resting and basing in that zone right now. And so really, if we look at a lot of these markets, look at the daily, you know, we're very divergent on the daily chart in the New Zealand dollar with the composite index. We are divergent in the pound dollar, and this to me is looking like a buy setup right here. It's looking like a buy zone. And the pound dollar. New Zealand dollar, same thing. Aussie dollar, looking a little bullish at this entry here. Looking maybe at a setup for a nice pullback. I think we have like just a little, not a lot of risk associated with this. If we were to, we'd say a 0.7503, I think, is a good entry. Pound dollar, possible short entry we're looking at, you know, or possible long entry, but no, I'm not gonna take a look at that one. New Zealand dollar, Aussie dollar, possible gold. Gold is a little bit more iffy right now. We'll have to come back to that one. Let's look at the dollar yen. Dollar yen is super extended, and we're actually probably in a good zone for a short here. Short at 109.77. And you know, our risk area is just really kind of above that at 110, essentially. Let me fix this. These entries are floating around in here. And I want to set my stop to 110. Set there? Yes, it did. Okay, cool. So that trade there is good. Gold, it's on the daily, it's looking like we may have a buy entry. We'll see though. Euro dollar, New Zealand dollar. Maybe the New Zealand dollar. Let's look at that. Well, I'd say that a safe entry here for kind of a long would be a return to, well, really, I guess the trade yesterday at 70.34. pound dollar. This is structurally looking like we could get a nice bounce here. Dang it. Ugh. It's a little. Let's entertain a long above this high here. 136.69. Now there's Fed news coming up, but here's the deal, all right? Like, we've had the dollar go up like crazy. And then we've had everything else fall down like crazy. And the Fed rate decision's coming up. And we know what that's going to be. So we know that price is already, looks like everything's already priced that in. So more than likely what happens is that news comes out, says there's a rate hike, but because it's already priced in, everything kind of goes wonky and goes the opposite direction. So like the dollar will fall. Because it's already going to fall before it goes back up again, and vice versa. So something to keep your eye on and be aware of as we're looking at the market today. You know, we already had ADP, but we have, where is it at here? Why can't I? Yeah, 1 o'clock. There it is. So I'm gonna be careful of our trades today. This is why I don't want to take a lot of trades. I want to take some of these really extended positions, but other than that, I mean, really, I would suggest, for me, staying pretty flat. Never a good idea to trade during all this jazz. But there are good opportunities in there. And, you know, looking at even the euro dollar here, we're looking at a little supportive entries here, possibly. We'll have to see how they play out, though. Lots of opportunities in front of us, though. So we'll have to see how it goes. I know I got a late start here. Sorry, guys. I have a busy morning. Did not intend for it to get so busy, but that is what happens. But we're certainly going to have a lot to talk about tomorrow with the fund rate. And hopefully, you know, today there's going to be the end of some of this kind of basing price action and this kind of lull that we're experiencing because of the Fed fund rate decision coming out. We should see a lot more, visible moves happening, because sometimes, you know, really, there's just not a good time to trade. And if it doesn't look like a good time to trade, don't trade. That's a really easy decision to make. Really short session today. And I will see you guys tomorrow. Bye-bye.